Hey, what's up guys? I am back. After a few weeks off, I have returned. And I figure in this video, we'll do a little range reflection with the Smith 686 Plus with the 4-inch barrel. Now, before I went off YouTube for a little bit there, I had already taken this out to the range to test fire it, what have you, and it's working A+, no problems whatsoever. I already put a bunch of different 357 Magnums through this, and it handles it with ease. But since I'm going out towards a public range, I figure I'd stop by there and try to get a little bit of range footage for you guys so you can check out what it looks like, I guess, shooting some Magnum loads. Now, basically, what I want to do with this revolver is focus on shooting 357s through this versus, say, 38 Specials. So today, I'll bring along some Critical Duty, which is a 135 grain Magnum. I have a case of this stuff, so I got plenty of this on hand. And this should be a good round through the 4-inch barrel. Also, I have some 158 grain Magnums I could blast through it just for the hell of it. So I'll bring some of these along. But what I really like shooting out of this thing is the Buffalo Bore. All right, this is a heavy 357 Magnum, 180 grain lead flat nose. This is a punchy round. Again, I have like three boxes of this left. And I've already shot quite a few of these rounds through this. And it's a very, very punchy and actually dirty round. But I was considering carrying this as a trail gun, you know, when I go off into the woods, possibly against black bear, because we do run into black bears, but they're of no real threat. But just in case, this would probably be a decent bear defense round, possibly, for black bear. You know, as an example, I had already taken this thing out on one of my hikes, you know, in the woods, and I carried it on the strong side hip, and we did run into three black bears. Check it out. So most of the times these black bears, they're more scared of us, you know, like I said, and they don't pose any real threat. But I had this on me while we did that little hike, and I was kind of glad that I did. But again, I have this other thought in my mind on getting a different type of revolver from a buddy of mine. So just stay tuned on that, because I believe that's going to happen pretty soon. So without further ado, let's pack up, let's get going and get to the range. So the next scene should be of me shooting this bad boy at a public range. So hopefully there'll be no issues, problems, geez, you know. Every time I go to the public range, there's always something, you know, going on. But, all right, let's get going. All right, it was a successful range visit. I basically focused on shooting 357 Magnums out of this thing today at the public range. I did start out with shooting 38 Specials, and guys, honestly, 38 Specials out of this is pretty much, it feels like a 380, you know, so the recoil is almost non-existent, 38 Specials. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna focus on 357 Magnums. And I had a bunch of the Critical Duty 135 grain Magnums, and I had a box of Buffalo Bore 180 grain lead flat nose Magnums. So quite honestly, 135 grain Magnums, the Critical Duty out of this is extremely manageable. I mean, the recoil is like, I don't know, it's not that big of a deal. Unless I'm really used to like heavy recoil, since I've been shooting 460 Magnum and 454 Casull, I don't know, in 10 millimeter, you know, hot 10 millimeter, that 135 grain Magnum Critical Duty out of this revolver is cake. It's a cakewalk. And you guys saw through that the footage that I put up, it's really not that big of a deal at all. I mean, it really isn't. The 180 grain buffalo boar, however, all right, now that one was a bit punchy. All right, it was, you can feel the concussion to the face, and the guy in the port next to me actually stopped shooting his 40 caliber M&P, and he was like just watching me. I hate when people do that, you know, I guess that's just the public range. But after I was done shooting 7 rounds of that buffalo boar, he asked me, "Hey, what are you shooting? What is that?" I said, .357 Magnum. "Wow, damn, man." He's like, "I could feel that you know, power in the, you know, in my port. How much longer are you gonna be shooting? Really? Freaking rushing me? I mean, too bad. I'm shooting my 357 Magnums." But I'd assume it's the buffalo boar that bothered him. So, whatever. I continued shooting the buffalo boar because that would be most likely a bear defense round if I ever wanted to use one. And it is a very punchy round, but it's controllable. Now, it shook these grips loose. And so these grips are about to fall off. So I'm going to have to tighten that screw or Loctite them in. But yeah, the 180 grain Magnums really loosened up these grips to the point of the screw back completely out. Wow. So anyways, good range visit. Enjoyed shooting this thing. This is really not a problem. Recoil is extremely controllable with the 4-inch barrel, full stainless steel L frame. It's really not a problem, guys. So if you're interested in getting a 357 Magnum, definitely I would pick one of these up and shoot some hot mags through it. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. Not buffalo boar now. Buffalo boar is on a different level. And Underwood, I didn't shoot any Underwood, but Underwood is definitely on another level. But if you're going to shoot like critical defense, critical duty Magnums, even some of the Federal 357 Magnums, and even 158 grain Magnums, it's really not a big deal. So just want to let you guys know, A plus, great revolver, works out fine. Alright guys, that's about it for this video. So as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.